back to another episode of Skate Line MBD, and we just checked the score. Mike Palooza 432, flat bar 0. Spitfire takes the scenic route, and Rowan Davis leads us through the land down under. Even though his beanie says Moscow, Russia, this nigga had the Putin flip. I ain't never seen the beanie be that high up. Whatever USSR you got going on up here, I'm with that. It's not Cold War no more. I can back that. That was a hard name. Think about it, nigga. USSR. That was like us or, son. Bro, Australia don't put out none of the legends, no way. There's a long list of people. Shane O'Neal, the list could stop there. You see where I'm at now? That's fucked up, because I'm really trying to get into Rowan Davis. But since I said Shane O'Neal, now your brain's going crook, Nolly Big Inwood Hill picnic table 5 years ago. And I now fucked him up, because you can't unthink about Nolly back here, Wallenberg, the dude's done everything. My point is Rowan, I'm sorry, I might have snatched that from you. This week's damn nigga, Pop Lock and Yakin. Goes to Mr. Oyonin.
Toot that thing up, mommy, make it roll. Want your pop lock, y'all can go to fakie when you go. Oh!
Straight from the mouth of madness comes Martino Cantaneo. What I was looking for. I was like, I gotta see a part of this guy before I really know, and I do enjoy it. You are good as hell. Only thing I don't get is why you got a tiny ass top knot for a ponytail and you not practicing the art of Bushido. When are you gonna crawl over the Great Wall of China and take over China itself? I don't know. That's the story of Mulan, that's all I got. Disney be trying to teach me things. Until you really read, you don't know a damn thing. Did anybody else have to take an ibuprofen just to watch Zero's Painkiller? Because bro, what the hell? Chris Wyman, Dane Berman, and Thomas Sandoval took the old man bow out. They was like, bitch, we been did this. It hurts. We got two clips of some gnarly, and we out the way. Forrest Edwards pulled up like, look, the go-to tricks are still the way they are. But nobody's paying attention to Brandon, the greaser, Burleigh. He even have a full punt. He did some shit that's gonna change the game forever. Hair grease back. He don't even use mousse. Just take a good, pow, throw it back. Do some dumb shit on the kink rail. And I love that. And then he was even dumber than him. I think if the Leap of Faith was around, Cannon Dern would have tried to shit switch. This nigga had a part full of failures and close things that was so stupid that we still had to see that he was willing to try him and then a part. These motherfuckers have done it yet again. If you wanna join us this Black Friday, we are having a candlelight vigil for Blubber because the spot is fucking dead. Mark Suchu went there and did very unnecessary things to it. We're actually gonna start a GoFundMe to have the marble removed, be placed into the Smithsonian after Suchu's third part in 1 month. Hopefully we can do the $1 million that we need because I need to pocket $750,000 of that. I got my own ideas, but $250K will be actually used towards the thing itself. Don't pay attention to the numbers or the factors. Hey Gary, why are you not screaming at the top of your lungs? I've lost my mind. Deep inside, the soul that I have, he learned how to break dance, and he's spinning on his head right now. But this Gary right here, my astral projection onto the camera, is trying to talk to you calmly without yelling at you and slobbering and spitting and shit. Thank you, and I hope you had a great Thanksgiving this week. Doesn't say what I'm trying to say to Mark Suchu. Three parts in 1 month. Y'all see the eye twitching? I probably need to take my medication right now. Yeah, I can't find it. I can't fucking find it. This is good night from another episode of Skate Line MBD, and Brandon, Burleigh us out. This wraps another episode of Skate Line MBD. I just saw a YouTube video of how they make a tire. Shit was crazy. Go check it out. Two links. Car tires, nigga, rims, all. It's crazy. Changed my life.